St. John to Copeland's camp. It's done. The radio tower's locked down, and I've restored your radio uplink.
Copy that. You may not see the value in a St. John, but Radio Free Oregon is the only thing keeping us from turning into savages.
No, Cope, the only thing keeping us from turning into savages is about 9 square meals. Try going hungry for 3 days. There's no such thing as a starving patriot.
Well, sir, I hope to God you're wrong about that.
Radio Free Oregon. Jesus, what have I done?
Deke, you got your radio on? I crafted you a couple of items if you want to swing by.
Loser, thank you. Yeah, I'll stop by later.
Boozman, you awake? I'm heading to that camp you spotted north of the mountain.
I heard gunshots. It might be an ambush camp.
Find out when I get there. Deacon out.
Well, we're all homeless now. Living in the wilderness.
Boozman, you were right. They set up along the railroad tracks.
Kill every one of the sons of bitches.
That was kind of the plan. Deacon out. Could make something out of this. Let's see.
Thank you. I'll just take these.
That's the last of them.
Stay the hell off O'Leary Mountain.
Boozer, it's done. Squatter camp. They won't be doing any more killing on O'Leary Mountain.
Good. Deke. I should have been there. To help, I mean, I...
Shit. Just rest up, Booze Man. Rest up. We're riding north as soon as your arm heals. You got that?
Yeah, I hear you. Boozer out. You heading out?
Yeah, I'm gonna ride up to the cemetery and... see if I can find Leon's stash.
Sorry. What was that?
Rest up, Boozer. We're heading north as soon as you can ride.
North. Yeah. Deke, you there? Did you say you were heading north?
Booze Man, no. You know, I wouldn't ride north without you.
Yeah, I know. I just kinda out of it.
Well, third degree burns will do that to you.
Yeah. So, take care of Alvarez, you know. Deke. It means a lot to me.
I'll take care of her, Boozer. Just get some rest. Deacon out. Raiders. Damn it. I should have been watching for him. Boozer, no, you're gonna get yourself killed. You gotta wait till you're whole, brother. I'm over here anyway, so I'll take care of the nest, okay?
Yeah, okay. Thanks, Deke.
Deke, wait till tonight. Freaks inside those nests. Take my wound still by the
drifters coming in my camp, killing folk like we were out in the shit.
What's going on, Cope?
A man come in, drugged, out of his mind, shot the place up, then he just took off. Manny said his bike's got a red tank on it, and he was wearing some kind of... a motocross helmet, silver.
Okay, if I go now, I might be able to catch up to him.
I want him alive, Deke.
Alive?
Alive. You catch this man. Then radio me. We'll fetch him and hang the bastard right from that limb. It's time we start showing these drifter sons of bitches that we have law and order in this camp. No offense meant to yourself.
None taken. I'll find him.
Yeah, not bad.
This is it. Yeah, oh, this camp is gonna be crawling.
Nah, you gotta leave the bike out here, Deke, or it'll pull all of them down on you.
God damn it, what you all shit yourself at once? Jesus Christ. Getting kind of cold out. Okay, one nurse done. How many more you got? This place is a death trap. Goddamn freaks, what the hell are you doing in here, I bet that blows up real good. Here, yep.
It'll warm you up. Thank you.
That's all of them in here.
I'll come back later, burn out these nests. Sleeping. Don't pay no attention to me. Is that the last of them? Finally.
Ethan.
Boozer, it's done. I cleared those nests. Should be less freaks on the mountain from now on.
How'd it go? Were there a lot of them?
Nah, it wasn't too bad. That's why I wanted to take them on while it's dark out. Some of them were strong as hell, though.
Yeah, cold makes them stronger. But you knew that.
Yeah, Boozer, I knew that.
Anyway, well, thanks for doing that, Deke.
Get some shut-eye, Boozer. Deacon out.
St. John, this is Copeland. I haven't seen Boozer in a few days. He used to do runs for me, is all. I know he's riding. Tried to radio him. Can't seem to reach him. Well, you see him, you tell him to swing by and say hello to Cope. Much appreciated. Copeland out.
Come on!
Thank you.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This Earth is a gift for us all, to use as we see fit, to provide for ourselves and our families. I'm not saying this. It's the Lord that gave us dominion over it. But that wasn't enough for some men. They wanted more. When our fuel got low, they jacked up the prices so they could consolidate power into their own hands. So, we wanted to build dams for electricity. But their precious runs of salmon were more important than heating our homes. We wanted to cut a few trees to build those homes. But the nests of a few spotted owls were more important than the entire timber industry. Now that the feds have gone to ground, let's just say we've eliminated the middleman. No one can stop us from taking what's rightfully ours. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Thing is, Cope, fuel prices have come down lately. Way down. Only problem is you gotta find it yourself. And last I checked, there were plenty of...
everything.
too bad. Oh, I know.
shit. Cut it out.
Weeping Angel. This has got to be it. Now, where'd you hide the stash, Leon? Okay, let's take a look around. This is really interesting. What do we got? Maybe in one of these. I just gotta figure out how I'm gonna get this to him.
Boozer! Boozman, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A new chopper! It just buzzed right over me and acted like I wasn't even there!
All this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
I'm gonna chase him down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. Don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid. Huh!
see what I can do.
Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
Hmph!
Yeah.
We got enough fuel to get back. We're going all over hell and back today.
We got plenty of fuel. I double checked.
Seems like it's always raining out here.
Shit. It's cold.
Heat on in your suit? Feel
okay,
stop!
Okay.
Right there!
I'm leaving.
That ought to distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
We are authorized to shoot on site.
Leaving.
Distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, that's O'Brien.
Got it.
Oh shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Must be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage three.
Then what the hell happened to Sarah? No, forget everything.
We are authorized to shoot on site.
We can be friends now, can't we?